You don't see nobody coming around the altar or kneeling and praying anymore. Have you?
Yeah.
I know it's back there on the wall, Brother Billy's going to have a prayer meeting.
Yeah.
The 30th.
Yeah.
I promise you, if he had somebody coming here, if he had your favorite singer coming in here.
Come on.
Your number one singer, whoever it may be, yeah. A Crab family, whoever coming in here, and he tell you, you're going to get an opportunity to speak to him.
Yeah.
You don't want to be here.
Yeah. Come on.
But the 30th, you're going to get an opportunity to speak to the one that died on Calvary. One of them will be here then, amen?
Yeah.
That's the one that's most important. We're missing it on the kind of prayer. He said, my house shall be called a house of prayer.
Come on.
Amen?
Yeah.
You know, I know everything seems like it's fast-paced nowadays, but sometimes we need to slow down.
Yeah.
We need to slow down, stop and drop and pray. Amen.
Come on.
We need to take time out of our busy schedule, amen, to talk to the master a little bit.
Come on.
That's the reason we mess up so much, amen. When it seems like we get mad and everything's going on in our life, and we just keep on pushing through it.
Yeah.
If we'd stop and drop and pray.
Come on.
If we'd stop and ask the Lord to guide us, amen.
Come on.
If he'd lead us, honey, I guarantee you wouldn't have to go through battles as hard as we go through. Amen. You remember when Paul and Silas was in prison over in Acts the 16th chapter?
Yeah.
Amen. They'd been beaten. But they didn't sit there, Brother Billy, and moan and complain. If it had been me, I said, Lord, why'd you put me in this place? What have I done to get here? And they were moaning and complaining. But that ain't what they done. Amen. They took time to stop and drop and pray at midnight. Even though they'd been beaten. And even though they'd been locked up and didn't know what the outcome was going to be, they took time to pray to Jesus. Took time out, even though everything was going on, honey, because it took time to pray.
Come on.
Amen. There was an old jailer there, Sister Minnie, amen, that didn't know the Lord. Didn't know nobody. He was the guard at the prison. His job was to keep him in prison.
Yeah.
But because of the prayer, him and his household got saved.
Come on.
Honey, it pays to stop and drop and pray.
Yeah. Amen.
You hear all the time, you know, when this praise first comes to my mind, the first thing I thought about, Sister Minnie's at the fire department that teach kids. If you catch on fire, if you hear something catch on fire, stop, drop, and roll. Amen. But when I heard this, when this come into my mind, Brother Billy, stop, drop, and pray.
Yeah.
I thought there's something to keep you out of the fire. Amen.
If
we stop, drop, and pray, honey, it's something that'll keep you out of the eternity fire. We won't have to burn forever. But we're going to have to do some praying.
Come on.
You can't make it without prayer.
Come on.
If you ain't spending some time talking to him, honey, you won't make it.
Come on.
Amen. You cannot get saved by prayer.
Yeah.
Amen. But everything that you need will come through prayer.
Amen.
If you need a healing, stop, drop, and pray.
Come on.
Amen. If you need deliverance, stop, drop, and pray. If you need salvation, stop, drop, and pray. Our answer is in prayer. Amen. That's where our answer is for this country. Amen. And we'll turn back. Amen. In 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, it's my people.
Come on.
Which are called by my name will humble themselves. Let me read it. I'll mess it up. I can't quote it any further, probably. I've quoted it 1,000 times. It says, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my faith and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sin and heal their land.
Come on.
If my people will humble themselves, he wants somebody to be humble, amen?
Yeah.
And a lot of people, they don't want to come up because they're afraid somebody's going to see them kneel at the altar.
Come on.
Honey, it's time for us to be humble, amen? And it's time for us to pray. That's the answer for our country. Our answer ain't in our next president. But I think we need a new one, amen?
Come on.
That ain't where our answer lies, amen? Our answer lies in Jesus, amen? He's the one who's got the answer. He's the one. He's still in control, church, amen? I don't care who they put in that White House. God is still in control, amen? He's still going to have the final say no matter what goes in that White House and what don't go.
Come on.
Amen? But it all comes through prayer, church. Prayer changes things, Sister Minnie. Amen? It changes situations. The Bible says he knows what we have need of before we ask.
Yeah.
But he didn't say he didn't want us to ask, Brother Bill. He said we have not because we ask not. Amen.
Yeah.
He wants us to ask. He already knows what Brother Bill needs. Amen. He already knows what I'm going to be facing tomorrow or the next day. He knows what I need.
Yes, he does.
But he still wants me to ask, Brother Bill.
Come on.
He wants to talk to us. He wants us to separate our time and spend a little time with him and talk to him.
Yeah.
That's the answer for our country. If my people, which are called by my name, humble themselves.
Yeah.
Amen. And pray. Seek my face. And see, we got to do some turning.
Come on.
Amen. A lot of people, I've seen people come to the altar, but they don't do no turning. And then when they get back up from the altar, the same thing was in when they left.
Yeah.
Got to make some changes. It's like that president, reason he got elected, he's preaching on changes.
Yeah.
He was going to do this, and he ain't done nothing. Amen.
Come on.
But the one I'm talking about are changes.
Come on.
If we'll do some praying, if we'll stop and drop and pray and ask him to move in our life, honey, I promise you, he'll move.
Yeah.
But we're too busy. We're caught up in everything else. Amen. We ain't got time. Just like that rich man that had plenty. He had everything, Brother Billy. He had so much crop and stuff. He said, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to tear down these barns, build new barns for the.
Come on.
For I can restore my fruit. Amen.
Yeah.
He had so much stuff, but he got caught up in it. Amen. And the Lord said, thy food, tonight, thy soul will be required of thee.
Come on.
Amen. He should have been stopping, dropping, and praying. Amen. Still all caught up in the things of this world. The rich man, when he died and went to hell, and they said he just took some time out, Brother Billy. He was caught up on the worldly goods. He was caught up on everything that a rich man could own. He had a big house upon a hill, plenty to eat, and had all this stuff. But he didn't do no stopping. Dropping and praying.
Yeah.
Honey, we need to stop, drop, and pray. Amen. There was a beggar laying at the gate. Amen. He doesn't pray. The Bible says they knew his name. Amen.
Yeah.
So his name was written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. That's the most important thing of tonight. Amen. Does he know our name? Is our name written down? And we've been doing some stopping, dropping, and praying. Amen. We need to stop. And get out of our old busy schedule and get out of everything that's going on around us. Stop and pray. I'm telling you, church, the church needs to get prayer back in the church. Amen. We need to get it back in our homes, back in our churches. We growl about it because it ain't in our schools.
Yeah.
Amen. But we ain't doing it in our homes. Amen. We'll growl about it because the Ten Commandments ain't hanging on the walls of the courthouse. But honey, how many homes have you got it hanging in it? Amen. We talk about this and that and that. The government done this, the government done that. Honey, we done most of it. We're putting the blame on everything but us.
Come on.
We need to take time for Jesus. Amen. I'm telling you, church, this thing is wrapping up.
Yeah.
And we're going to miss it. If we don't pray. If we don't do some seeking. And finding his will in our life. Then we want to go. We want to do everything our way. And I promise you, your way ain't God's way.
Come on.
Amen. Your way, because you want to do this or that. That may not be what God wants you at. Amen. He's got a place for you in your life. Amen. He's got a path for you to travel. And the only way you'll find it is in prayer. The only way we'll find it. Brother Billy, the only way I can get a message from the Lord is through prayer.
Yeah.
Amen. I know there's people that can get them off the internet, but it won't do you a bit of good. Amen. Because God knows what we have need of. The people out there on the internet don't know what I have need of. Amen. But he does. Amen. And if I pray and we'll seek the Lord, honey, he'll answer. He'll be right there for us. He's never failed. Sometimes he don't come like we think it ought to come. Amen. And sometimes we don't get the answer we want.
Come on.
But he will answer. He will answer. Because he wants his will. That's where we got to get, church. We got to get on his will. His will to be done in our life.
Come on.
No one's going to get there, Sister Minnie. It's through prayer. Stop dropping the praying. Amen. The church needs to get it back in. Amen. Most churches will have an open prayer and a closing prayer.
Come on.
No other praying going on.
Yeah.
Amen. Most churches, most people to come to church, the only word to get is what they get at church.
Yeah.
They, when they get home or sitting around the house, they don't pick up their Bible. They'll pick up everything in the world in the house.
Come on.
They'll pick up their TV guides.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord. They'll pick up all kinds of magazines that shouldn't be in the house to start with.
Uh-oh.
Amen. But they don't pick this up. Honey, we'd better start praying some time with him. I'm telling you, church, he's getting ready.
Come on.
He's getting ready to blow that trumpet.
Come on.
And if we ain't ready, we ain't going, Sister Reese.
Come on.
We got to be ready, honey. Well, I've been in this thing a long time, but you still better be seeking God, amen.
Come
you
on.
Better still be serving him, amen. You better be a 34 Christian, you better be striving to be a 60, amen. If you're 60, you better be striving to be 100, amen. And so he's coming back. It's a church that's made herself ready.
Come on.
It's up to us to get ready, Sister Reese. He done paid, he done bought the ticket on Calvary.
Yeah.
It's paid for in full. Amen. If you go to hell, it's because you chose to.
Yeah.
Amen. It'd be because you didn't take time to stop, drop, and pray.
Come on.
Amen. There's people in the hell today because they didn't take time to stop, drop, and pray. Amen.
Come on.
They didn't take time because they had too much pride, maybe. Pray somebody's going to see them. I believe with all my heart you'll remember every altar call that you've ever heard.
Amen.
When you're in hell. That would be hell enough, Brother Billy.
Yeah.
Knowing that I had an opportunity.
Come on.
that some preacher got up, and I felt the anointing of God, and I know that he was calling me to step out, but I let my pride get in my way, and I just kept hanging on to the seat, and I wouldn't come to no altar. That would be hell enough.
Yeah.
Not counting the flames and the torment where the worm died not. Amen. It's going to be a terrible place, Brother Billy, and it's soon coming. It's real, just like heaven's real, and it soon come to pass. Amen. You're either going to go to one place or the other, and it's up to us. Amen. So we better start doing some praying.
Come on.
We better be getting serious, church. Amen. It's time the church to start being the church. Amen. Start being real for God. Amen. Start serving Him with everything we got. Amen. Yeah. Like that song I'm saying, He give us everything. We ought to be giving Him everything. Yeah. We ought to be going with it. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. And everything else, Sister Mitty, everything else I've got need of, if I seek God first, He's going to take care of it.
Come on.
He's got to. His word says He would. If I seek Him first, everything else, He'll take care of it. He'll take care of it, Brother Billy. He'll take care of my finances. He'll take care of my health. He'll take care of everything I need if I seek Him first. But we got to be seeking. Amen. Amen. And you got to seek Him through His word and through prayer. That's the only way you can find Him. Amen. He wants to talk to us, church. He wants to speak to us. Amen. He wants us to be real for Him. But we got to take time. We got to shove our busy schedule away. And I know it's anymore, it seems like everything's busy. Fast paced. But we got to take time to pray. Stop, drop, and pray.
Come on.
It's the most important thing we can do, Brother Billy.
Yeah.
But I want to be ready. I don't want to miss it. There's nothing in this world that I'd go to hell over. Well, ain't nothing in this world worth going to hell over. Nothing, Brother Billy. Amen. This thing is just temporary.
Yeah.
We're just passing through. We're strangers. We're just passing through. But one of these days, we're going to spend eternity somewhere. And it all going to depend whether you stopped off and prayed or not.
Yeah.
That's what it's going to depend on. Amen. It don't matter how many prayers your pastor said for you. Have you said it? Does he know your name? Is your name written down in that Lamb's Book of Life? You can have your name on every church book in McLean County. That won't get you there.
Come on.
You can shout in these aisles every Sunday or every Tuesday night. That won't get you there.
Yeah.
If your name is not written, and brother, I believe our names are written in that blood.
Oh, hallelujah.
That is shed on Calvary. Amen. When we stand before that judgment seat, I believe that's what He's going to look. He's going to look and see what the blood has to say. Amen. Is He really washed in the blood? Is His sins covered up? There's nothing left. There's nothing to judge me for. Yeah. You can't judge somebody for something that ain't there.
Come on.
And if that blood has covered it, it ain't there no more.
Yeah.
It's gone. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He said He told it behind me.
Yeah.
It's in the sea. Too many people fish for the things that you used to be in.
Come on.
They're fishing for your old things that you used to have in your life. They're fishing where God told them to block everyone to see. And that stuff needs to be left back there. Amen. And I ain't saying forget where He brought you from, because we need to remember where He brought me from. I thank God for where He brought me from, Brother Bill. I mean, I guarantee you that was a miracle in my life. And man, that's the greatest miracle you'll ever know. It's when you got saved. It's the greatest miracle.
Amen.
That's more greater than any healing that you could ever get. Amen. Because that there is going to last forever. Amen. You may get healed in your body. And you may die tomorrow. That healing ain't going to last forever.
Yeah.
But the healing I'm talking about is eternity. When you accepted that blood of Jesus Christ and it healed you, it's for eternal. It's forever and ever and ever.
Come on.
But we got to pray. We got to seek His face and turn from our wicked ways and do whatever He wants us to do. Live our life for Jesus. Amen. Be a light to a lost and dying world. Honey, there's people out there dying and going to hell because they don't see no light. They can't, just like a ship coming down in the sea, if they can't see that lighthouse, Brother Billy.
Come on.
And the fog and stuff like that, he don't know where to go. Amen.
Yeah.
But if we shine a light and let people know, let them see Jesus through us. Amen. Then they'll know where to go. They'll know who to turn to. They'll know that that man changed me. That man changed you. So there's still hope. Amen. They'll know that I know how Sister Minnie used to be, but now I see how God has changed her. Amen. And turned her life around. I know that if He's done it for her, He'll do it for me. See, that's the kind of light we need to be, church.
Come on.
And there's people watching us. Amen. He's watching us. Stop, drop, and pray. Amen.
Amen.
Trust the Lord. We're going to let even here, Brother Billy. This thing is about over. I believe it with all my heart. I believe that trumpet is getting ready to sound.
Yes.
And He's going to call us up out of here if we're ready.
Amen.
But if you're not ready, if you don't know Him, you better be getting ready.
Come on.
You better stop. Take time to stop, drop, and pray, and ask the Lord to come in your life. It ain't no hard thing to do. All you got to do is ask Him. Just believe. First, you got to believe in your heart that He came and died on Calvary. And on that third day, He rose again. Then all you got to do is ask Him, Brother Billy, to forgive you of all your sins.
Come on.
And He'll take them and He'll wash them from away. And He'll change our life from around. But we got to ask. Amen. He's not going to force feed us. He's not going to make us take it.
Yeah.
But it's free. And we just accept it.
Amen.
Amen. That's what the Lord gave me. Give the Lord a happy word.
Amen.